Hey everyone, welcome back to another edition of Ask the ND. I'm Dr. Jeremy Wolf. I've been getting a lot of questions about the differences between the various types of protein powders on the market today. Let's face it, if you walk through any health food store, you'll see shelves full of protein powders. It's hard not to get overwhelmed. In this episode of Ask the ND, I'm going to break down the various types of protein supplements to help make your decision just a little easier. Protein is one of the nutrients, along with carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, minerals, and water, that our bodies need to function. Proteins are composed of small units called amino acids, which are considered the building blocks of protein. Protein is primarily used to build, maintain, and repair body tissues. Common food sources of protein include both animal and plant sources. Plant sources include beans, legumes, seeds, nuts, grains, and vegetables. Animal sources include meat, fish, eggs, poultry, and dairy. The amount of protein our body requires is dependent upon age, size, physical activity level, health status, as well as diet and many other factors. In general, adults in the US are encouraged to get around 10 to 35% of their daily calories from protein. This translates to about 46 grams of protein for women and 56 grams of protein for men. Let's take a closer look at the different types of protein supplements and how they function in the body. Here's the rundown. Whey protein is the protein contained in the watery portion of milk that separates from the curds when making cheese. Therefore, if you are sensitive to dairy or have a dairy allergy, then whey may not be the protein for you. Whey is considered a complete protein because it contains all the essential amino acids. It has been shown to promote muscle growth while stimulating fat loss. Pea protein is an excellent source of protein for those on restricted allergy diets or who are vegan or vegetarian. Peas are naturally fat and cholesterol-free and can provide a boost of energy before a workout. Similar to whey, pea protein also supplies the body with high levels of branched-chain amino acids, which are needed for protein synthesis. Lastly, pea protein is easily digested and used by the body. Soy protein is a type of protein that is isolated from the soy bean. It's roughly 90 to 95% protein and contains amino acids needed for growth. An important side note is that most soybeans grown in the US are genetically modified. If you're avoiding GMOs, it's important that you look for a certified, organic, or non-GMO soy protein. Rice is another alternative protein for those on restricted diets or who are vegetarians. It supplies the body with all the essential amino acids and may even help to build muscle and aid in muscle recovery after workouts. When considering a rice protein, it's important to look for a quality product free of heavy metals and other toxins. Egg protein is gaining a lot of popularity these days. Majority of the egg protein is from egg white protein isolate. If you're looking to stimulate muscle growth while increasing protein synthesis, egg protein is a great choice. This is because it contains all the essential amino acids and it is easily digested by the body. Plant-based formulas are often hypoallergenic formulas, free of common food irritants, making them easier on the stomach. They contain a blend of specific foods such as peas, quinoa, artichokes, hemp, amaranth, and rice. Because of this, they contain an excellent variety of amino acids while also delivering a respectable amount of protein. A protein's use is determined by the type and amounts of amino acids contained on the protein molecule. When it comes to choosing your protein supplement, it's important to keep in mind the goal you are trying to accomplish. For instance, if you're trying to lose weight, you might choose a protein powder that has fewer calories and fewer grams of protein. While if you're trying to gain weight, you might choose a protein powder that has higher calories and also has higher grams of protein and fat content. Thank you for watching another edition of Ask the ND. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for weekly tips to help you on your journey towards happy wellness. From all of us here at Lucky Vitamin, spread the wellness.